For the entrance hymn, we shall take A65. I place my hand in your hand.
I place my hand in your hand, and joyously I fall along with you, O Lord. I place my hand in your hand, and joyously I fall along with you, O Lord. You call me friend, no longer slave. Your loving self for me you gave, and all mankind you came to save. So I'll follow you. I place my hand in your hand, and joyously I go along with you, O Lord. I place my hand in your hand, and joyously I go along with you, O Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, our God is a covenantal God, God who is always faithful to his promises, God who is always loving. Today's liturgy presents to us Moses as a model of faith in this loving God. Today's liturgy also brings to our notice that we need to be aware of the false prophets. By our fruits we shall know the type of persons we are. Faith is one of the fruits God has showered on us. In this Eucharistic celebration, let us ask for his grace to make us faithful to his covenant. And for the times we have been unfaithful and unloving, let us ask for his pardon.
I confess
to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me
to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Please bring to mind your intention. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In those days, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision. Fear not, Abram, I am your shield. Your reward shall be very great. But Abram said, O Lord God, what will you give me, for I continue childless, and the heir of my house is Eliezer of Damascus? And Abram said, Behold, you have given me no offspring, and a member of my household will be my heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came to him, This man shall not be your heir. Your very own son shall be your heir. And he brought him outside and said, Look towards heaven and number the stars, if you are able to number them. Then he said to him, So shall your offsprings be. And he believed the Lord, and he counted it to him as righteousness. And he said to him, I am the Lord who brought you out from Ur of the Chaldeans to give you this land to possess. But he said, O Lord God, how am I to know that I shall possess it? He said to him, Bring me a heifer 3 years old, a female goat 3 years old, a ram 3 years old, a turtle dove and a young pigeon. And he brought him all these, cut them in half, and laid each half over against the other. But he did not cut the birds in half. And when birds of prey came down on the carcasses, Abram drove them away. As the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell on Abram. And behold, dreadful and great darkness fell upon him. When the sun had gone down and it was dark, behold, a smoking firepot and a flaming torch passed between these pieces. On that day, the Lord made a covenant with Abram, saying, To your offspring I give this land, from the river of Egypt to the great river at the river Euphrates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, proclaim his name, make known his deeds among the peoples. O sing to him, sing his praise, tell all his wonderful works. Response: The Lord remembers his covenant forever. Glory in his holy name. Let the hearts that seek the Lord rejoice. Turn to the Lord and his great strength. Constantly seek his face. Response: The Lord remembers his covenant forever. O children of Abraham, his servant, O descendants of the Jacob, his chosen, He, the Lord, is our God. His judgments are in all the earth. Response: The Lord remembers his covenant forever. He remembers his covenant forever, the promise he ordained for 1,000 generations, the covenant he made with Abraham, the oath he swore to Isaac. Response:
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Acclamation.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia.
Abide in me, and I in you, says the Lord. He who abides in me bears much fruit.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly are ravenous wolves. You will recognize them by their fruits. Are grapes gathered from thorn bushes or figs from thorn bushes? So every healthy tree bears good fruit, but the diseased tree bears bad fruit. A healthy tree cannot bear bad fruit, nor can a diseased tree bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. Thus, you will recognize them by their fruits." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, as you have heard in the introduction, today's liturgy invites us to focus on Moses as a model, as a hero of our faith. All of us have difficult situations on our spiritual journey. Abraham also had difficult situations. I said Moses, it is Abraham. He is called Abram, and in Genesis chapter 17, he will see his name being changed, verse 5, to Abraham. Abram had a difficult situation. The first one was he was childless. He was longing for a gift of a child. And God had promised him that he would be the father of the multitude of nations. But he had no kin. And therefore, he becomes so desperate. In this desperation, he proposes to adopt Eliezer, his servant from Damascus, to adopt him as his son and take him as his heir. But God challenges his plan and he tells him, "Your own son will become your kin, your heir." And you see, Abraham believes what God says, whatever God promises. The second difficult situation Abraham had to face is that of the promise of the land. He asked God, "How will I possess it?" In other words, is there any sign? And God tells him, I will show you. And that is the covenant we see God establishing with Abraham. The animals are cut into two pieces and they are laid against each other. God puts Abraham to sleep. And during that time, in his vision, dream, he sees God walks between those cut animals as a smoky, fiery pot and as a flaming torch. When two partners make a covenant, they say, if any of them fails to fulfill this covenant, then their plight will be like these cut animals. They will be dead. God knew that humans would never be able to faithfully fulfill the covenant. And therefore he puts Abraham to sleep. God alone walks between the animals prepared for sacrifice. And you see in the New Testament afterwards, God who becomes human like us has to die because of this human's unfaithfulness. God takes on himself the death of a human. The blood that was spilled over by killing those animals becomes a bond of life between God and Abraham in the first reading. In the New Testament, Jesus' blood becomes the bond of life between God and humans. The image of God that is presented here is an image of God who is a covenantal God, a faithful God, God who is faithful to his promises. And the human response to this faithful God is faithfulness, which we see in Abraham. Abraham teaches us how to trust the Lord, how to have deep faith in him, how to have powerful confidence in him, especially in difficult situations. So that was the fruit that is produced in Abraham by God, the fruit of faith. In the New Testament, Jesus also picks up this analogy of a fruit. And he says, beware of the false prophets. You shall know them by their fruits. Saint Paul also uses this analogy of the fruit when he speaks of the fruits of the Holy Spirit in Galatians 5, 22 to 23. Fruits of the Holy Spirit like love, joy, peace, patience, gentleness, self-control, purity. And Jesus also speaks about the fruits, not only in today's gospel, in John chapter 10, verse 38, and John chapter 14, verse 11. Jesus says, I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. If you don't believe my words, at least believe my works, my deeds. My deeds shall speak to you. So by the fruits you shall know the tree. Good fruit tree cannot bear bad fruits, and bad tree cannot bear good fruits. And you also see the decay of the tree does not happen overnight. Slowly the spoiling takes place within, step by step. And finally the end is death. If I don't produce the fruits of faith, of love, of peace, of all the divine things, then slowly we shall see the death taking place. The decay takes place if we focus within ourselves. And therefore God also asks us to introspect. He is asking us to evaluate from within whether we are getting decayed or whether we are still bearing good fruit. Have we lost faith? Have we grown in faith? Have we grown in love? Have we grown in patience, in peace? That is what Jesus wants us to teach us, wants us to learn. So my dear friends, let us put ourselves before the Lord, humbly before Him, accepting Him to be our covenantal God, God who has promised us heaven, like He promised Abraham, Canaan, the land of milk and honey. Let us believe that God, what God has promised, He will fulfill. And let us learn to respond to this promise in faithfulness like Abraham.
For the offertory we shall take hymn B9, United in One Body.
United in one body with Jesus Christ alone, we bring to you our offering of bread and wine, O God. We are the wheat of Christ. If we be ground in the mill of life, may we be found pure bread. United in one body with Jesus Christ the Lord, we bring to you our offering of bread and wine, O God. We are the grape of Christ. If we be crushed in the winepress of suffering, may we be found pure wine.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and for the good of all His holy Church.
Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through Him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim,
Holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Philip Neri, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Joseph Vaz, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
I am the good shepherd, and I lay down my life for my sheep, says the Lord. Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
For our recessional hymn, we shall take T46, Ave Maria.
As I kneel before you, as I bow my head in prayer, take a stain, make it yours, and fill me with your Plena, though.